Well, it was mainly verbal. Georgie was very strong-willed, and he would argue with you till he got his point over. Like all siblings in families, they called each other names, right? Which I never liked. You know, as a mother, you don't like your kids. Like, one was very dark, like tanned easily, so he was called a back the jam jar. And so to call George Puffton.
Okay, closer, George, go closer. That's better. The closer you go, the better for me.
Fantastic! Look at that trip! Did Ziggy Stardust?
He didn't like school either. Wasn't he chucked out of school?
Yeah, and unfortunately I worked at that school.
What did you do?
I was the dinner lady.
Okay, George, very close. Very close. And go a bit to your left, if you don't mind. Okay, just there. That is wonderful.
Fantastic!
That is wonderful.
When he got to about 15, he said, I used to hate you, man. You were always had your hands in the sink. You were always scrubbing clean. And I thought that's what mother's done. But like, I think, too, he resented the fact that his father didn't help. And you see, Georgie was finding his feet then and was answering him back. And don't let him talk to you like that, man. And if you want to wear that, you wear that. And see, Georgie could see all of that happening. And he didn't like it. And he did argue with his dad a lot. But he gave me a lot of courage, actually. Courage that I'd lost. Like from when I first got married.
We're looking. Okay, George, here we go. It's looking positively terrific. Nose to me a bit more, George. That's it, keep it.
The good thing about George is that fame has stayed with him.
Yes. Like, people keep saying, how come he's coming back all of a sudden? I went, excuse me, but he hasn't been anywhere.
He almost did go somewhere with a chaotic situation with drugs.
Yeah.
And you helped him out of that.
Yes. I wasn't aware what he was taking. And I didn't know what out of your head meant then. I mean, I know now he was out of his head, but at the time I thought, like, you know, why is he doing this? You know, I just couldn't fathom out. And then I spoke to Siobhan and she said, like, Mum, you know, he's taking drugs. Well, I was gobsmacked. You know, you've been given this gift and you're destroying yourself. And I remember putting him in front of the mirror because I know now that they don't see what you see. And I said, look at his shirt. He was half the size he is now. So skinny, it was frightening. Absolutely frightening. I mean, I have seen other people just before they died, looking like it. And I was absolutely petrified. I think one particular friend that died shocked him into a census, Trojan they called him. I think his death affected Georgie a great deal. And because I said, like, you know, are you going to be next, son? Did they say? Have I just to wait for a telephone call, you know, that you're next? I promise you, Mum, I'll stop. And he phoned the doctor himself and, you know, told him, I've got to stop. Who's that, George?
This is George, who's just going to appear behind you now. Or is it George O'Dowd?
Hello. Hey, darling. Fantastic. Yeah, fantastic.
Let's get on with it then. Thank you very much. Look at you, you're insecure, running down the street, screaming for attention, choker's lips and padded hips, everybody's laughing, but you don't care. You're sick and you're twisted, irreverent, so beautiful. Look at me, don't stare. Butterfly. Goodbye. Satan's shout.
In Russia.
Is everybody happy?
I'm happy.
Happy, George?
It's been a pleasure.
Oh, that's
also
really
thank
wonderful.
You so much. I really enjoyed doing it.
That's a wrap then. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Patrick's pictures often end up in Buckingham Palace. This one ends up in Selfridge's store, Oxford Street. At last, the dream comes true. The show hits the stage and there's no turning back.
Give me a freak. Any day of the week.
And we're not being audible to anybody. We're giving everybody a fair crack of the whip.
I'm comfortable with those you call demented.
I mean, we're making certain characters, Philip Salon, particularly nice.
With space between their ears that can be rented.
Was there any big moment when you fell out with either Chris or George?
To be honest, I would have thought there should be millions of moments like that, and it might be more dramatic viewing to say that, you know, we did, but we didn't.
What I knew, you'd be a freak too.
If I was to ask you what is the best song in the show, what would you
say? Pie in the Sky, without a doubt.
I see the humour, oh, and the tragedy.
It's one we wrote initially and then changed the tune because I felt that it sounded too like one of the others. So George just instantly said, well, how about this? And started singing. I grabbed the guitar and it came together in about 2 minutes.
Now who do we think we are? Set our plans to bright shining stars. There was meth in our madness, there's a rumor in the truth. There was love, but what's the use?
And that's where the magic is for me, when something just drops in your lap like that.
Touched by the hand of cool, I wanna be touched by the hand of cool.
Hello.
I wanna be touched by the hand of cool. I wanna be touched by the hand of cool.
Hello, the viewer.
I wanna be touched by the hand of cool.
It must have been a very weird experience for him. Very emotional, maybe cathartic, maybe it started, maybe it's, I don't know how it must be for him to see his life represented on stage, you know. It's the sort of thing that usually happens after you're dead, isn't it?
Ich bin Kunst, and you see.
I like Ich bin Kunst. I mean, I didn't always. I found it a poison chalice at first because it's, you can't do it by half. You have to really.